edition, of course, with Henry Sekanjako.
That's true. Mm.
Yes, your daily dose of ABBA today.
That's true.
We come not very easy. We just
give it all news and everything.
Yes, indeed.
The latest in the
yesterday. The NRM still went ahead with their party primaries, and that were the mayoral flag bearers polls and also the local council three and others. Of course, the polls were held yesterday, but still nothing new about them. They were still mad with violence. They were still mad with vote rigging. They were still mad with a lot of irregularities, as we shall look at it later. But also, Henry, a man carried a head of a child as a gift for the Speaker of the Parliament of Uganda.
How unspeakable.
How did, I can't find the right word, but yes, that happened. We're also going to look at 100,000 sickle cell testing kits held at Entebbe International Airport, and we're wondering, what's happening? All right, so join us, join the conversation on our socials at Urban TV Uganda and at Urban Television, as well as that is on Facebook, Urban TV Uganda, on Twitter, at Seka Henry on Twitter, LynnUG3 on Twitter, and Lynn Komjisha Facebook, as well as Seka Henry on Facebook.
That's true.
Now, diving into it, Henry, the NRM primaries, have been going on. This is the third week, of course.
Yeah, they started on Friday.
The other Friday.
The other Friday.
Then the next Friday.
Friday,
yeah. Yes, and now yesterday.
That's true.
So they were electing mayoral. Henry, what is going on?
Of course, unlike the LC5s, the local council for LC5, and this particular one for yesterday was a bit violent. What stood out for me is the elections in Nakawa West.
Mm-hmm.
There was a lot of chaos.
Absolutely, yes.
Where one of the presiding officers, he's called Viola Namundu, declined to rather try to announce one of the winners, Aluma. And then, of course, the voters, cited irregularities here and there. And when she tried to announce, these guys got up in arms. And, and she was forced to, to tow the results.
That's true. She actually, one of them tore her the declaration forms and fled.
Yeah, the presiding officer has to run away because
these guys
had turned violent.
That's not all. There were reports of inflated numbers of voters.
That's true.
Declaration forms ripped up. The example for Naguru, for Lower Naguru polls for local council three chairperson were cancelled as supporters moved from one line to another. Now, this created, of course, suspicion of double counting. So the returning officers, was forced to cancel.
That's true. That was confusing. I mean, how do you cross from my line and then to my opponent's line?
How can you be? How confused can
you? Does that show what, these guys have been talking about, that voter bribery, where, I give you money and then I tell you cross over to my line?
Though I think
this is what will happen?
Do you think this was a case of voter bribery? I think it was a...
Because by the time you cross, from my line to some other person's line, it means someone has bribed you.
So here's the case. You line up behind Henry, and midway you're like, oh no, I think I want to line behind Lynn.
Mm-hmm.
What creates that? I don't want to think it was voter bribery. I want to think it was some sort of confusion. You know how youth can be rowdy. I would want to know the kind of people that moved from one line to the other, because that would inform our
to me it is down to bribery, because if I'm going to vote for you, Lynn, and then voting takes place, and then at some point I cross over to some other person's line, I mean, there has to be something that has forced me to do that.
Maybe that's either that's money true.
Oh, I've seen you losing and I don't want to be part of the losers,
perhaps it is confusion. I would want to think it's confusion.
Maybe it's what happened, but it is crazy. It's really crazy.
So there was elsewhere in Machindye, results feared altered Then in Hoima somewhere, cancelled off, tear gas was everywhere. Yesterday, I think every district, okay, at most, many districts yesterday registered cases of violence and police firing tear gas dispersed some, you know, rowdy crowds. And it's very unfortunate.
And lean SOPs were abused. People
Of course, obviously.
SOPs
I mean, we have seen this go on in many of the just concluded primaries. So
when the cases go up, COVID cases go up, we shouldn't be scared that where are these coming from?
Talking of COVID, I don't know. The FDC yesterday was suggesting, because it's about to hold its primaries, actually even campaigns, they were suggesting that these guidelines put in place by the Electoral Commission be halted.
Yeah.
That they be, you know, no, that the word is be eased.
The SOPs.
Yes, the SOPs put in place should be
is the bit
made easier because
so does that mean that if I'm required to put on a mask, I shouldn't be putting on a mask?
I don't know exactly what they wanted, but their point was they wanted the masses to, you know, take part. And you know, the FDC has always ridden on the mass chaos and the rowdiness and the fanfare. I think that's a polite word to use.
Yeah, fanfare.
The fanfare. So I think
people like Kabesuje like
they're going to miss out on that, and that is their worry.
So, but okay, maybe they can control the crowds a bit. Okay, not controlling per se, but allowing a certain number of people. But you cannot say that relax, let people, you know,
exactly.
Crowd in big numbers. This is a big risk for us as a country.
They were calling for a relaxation.
There's no way we can allow that.
But then, moving on still on the NRM just concluded primaries of yesterday. There was tear gas, like I told you. There was malpractice in Kampala. And also lots of malpractice elsewhere as recorded. So you need to know how these ones ended. But then be reminded that the NRM also recorded some 375 petitions.
Yeah.
Now imagine they're going to add
on these.
They're
hitting 400 because by yesterday, I think they had hit 378.
Yes.
So you never know, by close of this week, maybe we'll be talking about 400.
Or 500.
Oh, 500.
Because look,
cases.
We have the mayor, we have the local council ones.
And police is saying that they're going to interest themselves in the matter. Those
cases
of forgeries and then a false declaration of results. So it's a matter that police, you know, is taking interest in.
Yes.
As they're only waiting for a report from the NRM Electoral Commission, and then they, you know, this will form basis for their investigation. But, you know, we hope guys that petitioned, you know, really get justice. Though I've heard Tango Doi saying that these are pity. These are pity petitions, seriously.
I mean, Tango has always actually called these petitions petty. This is not the first time I've heard him say that.
Sure.
He actually thinks people have not paid attention to their constituencies, and that's why they're having all these issues. All right, let's move away from the NRM primaries. A man... This is a very sad situation. Now, a man yesterday, allegedly, yesterday, he took a gift note. I am very mad at this man, first of all. I cannot even come around it. So he got time, wrapped a head of a child in a box, wrapped it up properly. I don't know how he moved to Parliament. And said, okay, guys, I have a gift for the Speaker of Parliament. How, the audacity, what kind of creature is this?
Because Parliament is, you know, it's a public place, everyone is allowed to go there. But then before you enter, you're scrutinized, you know, to see what you're carrying.
Okay? Especially if you're carrying gifts.
Exactly.
If you're for carrying like the gift. Speaker.
Because the policy is at Parliament that before, you know, you deliver that gift, it has to be checked for all, you know, MPs. If you say you bring a gift to a certain MP, the police, the security team has to check it to find out
what is
contained in there. Because, you know, you've had word of, you know, people using these gifts to poison.
Yes, to poison, to do anything.
Yeah, so it's a police at Parliament that whoever brings in such gifts is checked. And then, you know, it is through this process that police, the security at Parliament, was able to identify this guy and then what he was carrying.
Interesting. A very interesting and very disturbing. Guess what? So he walks in and he's behaving in a funny way, of course, very suspicious. And the police is like, you know what? okay, we need to check this person. Then he asks for sanitizer. He's like, I need to sanitize my hands.
Sure.
And then, once they figure out that he's carrying a head of a person, of a child, of a human being, they're like, okay, we have a problem on our hands. They sit him down. And guess what? Do you know what he tells them? I usually, this is a small gift. I usually carry big ones as well. But how?
Can you imagine?
How?
He was very confident.
How?
And seriously, that was really bad.
Well, later, as investigations continue, of course, they later find out that this man, from the details we have, is that he is originally from Bushenyi.
That's true.
Okay? Mm. So he came, he was staying in Kampala at some point. Then he went, because of the pandemic, he had to move back to his home and he walked. Yeah? So on walking, he reached Masaka. And then I think he got tired
and
sought shelter at a pastor's, you know, church.
That's true.
While there, allegedly, he was very, you know, good with kids and all that. Then one morning he says, okay, I'm feeling sick. I have a knife here. Let me take a walk with this little girl and get some medication from the bush. And
so
they have never seen both
girl.
Of them. They just heard about it now. This is crazy.
So
this
bad.
Is crazy.
Very bad.
So the police thinks they're still carrying on, of course, investigations.
But of course, as investigations go on, I think police need to interest in, you know, itself in testing this guy. He needs to go for a mental checkup.
That shouldn't be an excuse.
Yeah, much as some people are saying that he's very sober. But
yes.
I don't find him sober at all, because even at Parliament, when he was, you know, speaking to those security guys, his you know, statements were not very much coherent.
They were not, incoherent.
So, yeah, so, you know, telling them that I sometimes I carry much more bigger gifts than
imagine.
These. So
like,
I don't think he's a very sober
who
person.
Who in their right minds can say that?
Seriously.
Especially when you're carrying, oh my goodness, I don't even want to imagine.
So I think we need to interrogate this, because he's saying that he was asked to deliver that gift at a fee. That's about 1 million shillings. So,
yes.
You know, as we investigate this, we need to find out who sent him. Maybe someone sent him. We shouldn't take it for comment and all that. You need to
it's
come
nothing.
Out
it's
and...
Not, it's not funny at all.
You need
it's
to come
funny.
Out and find out who sent this person. Why was he delivering this particular gift to that? To the speaker, and of all gifts, why would he deliver human head?
That's terrible. That's terrible. So, yes, there we have it. It's, I think, a developing story. And, of course, as details come in, we'll keep updating you on, if, you know, the final verdict, final investigation. I hope we come to its conclusion and figure out either if he has a mental problem, and but still, that's no excuse for his actions. Yes, he can have a mental problem treated while he serves his sentence, because, man, you don't kill a child. You don't kill a... And I carry
bigger gifts than this.
This is so despicable.
And he's confident. I mean, even reach a police station, rather the CID in Chibuli, and you ask for sanitizer.
Sanitizer?
That I need first sanitizer.
Like, guys, I need to first sanitize
Why does he, in the first place, why is he fearing death, yet he killed an innocent girl?
Police has a whole big job to do. I don't know if I could contain something like
this
that.
This boy is very annoying.
All
I
right.
can imagine what the family is going through.
The family, imagine the trauma they've
the
had to go
the
through.
The,
this is the person they took.
It must be a very trying moment for them.
Of course, they took him under their shelter, you know.
And then he disappointed.
Poor little girl. Anyway, let's not get so sad. Okay, now let's move away from that. 100,000 sickle cell testing kits are held at Entebbe International Airport. Now, these ones were procured after the Kabaka birthday run last year.
That's
of course,
right.
If you remember so well, last year's theme was about sickle cell, and so they needed to procure more kits in partnership with the Ministry of Health, obviously. So there was a consignment that came with these testing kits to the airport, and they were, of course, held by NHAS. Yes. Which handles, as you can see on your screen, that is, imagine thousands of people came together, collected a huge sum of money to procure these kits, and they have been at the airport for the last 1 month.
The kingdom contributed about 200 million shillings that was given to Ministry of Health
to procure these kits.
And then 6 months down the road, these kits have not been delivered.
Six months. Imagine they arrived. Mm. They arrived, but 6 months later, there are no... Well, it is due to the unpaid demurrage fees of over 40 million Uganda shillings. Sure. And this is 6 months after the importation. They were procured after the birthday run, fundraiser. And before we can look at what that means, Henry, what is demurrage fees? Perhaps
demurrage fees is it's a fee that is associated with keeping an equipment or consignment past the contractual time.
Ah.
So that this means that this consignment was delivered on time, mm-hmm. but then it was not picked
in time
as agreed. Well.
So this is holding.
Exactly.
So you're holding cargo.
It's a holding fee kind of thing.
Ah, holding fee of sorts.
So, yes. So each day, there's a fee that is applied.
So where is the problem? Who is to blame for this fee?
So the ministry of, I think the ministry is saying that we are government. Why should we pay for this?
Uh-huh.
And they're saying that the consignment should be released unconditionally, without us, without the ministry paying the 41 million,
Absolutely.
Fee. Yeah.
It has now accrued to 41 million Uganda shillings, and the ministry says it does not have money to pay for it. The NHAS ought to, amicably.
Mm.
No, be humane,
yeah.
Though
NHAS is making money, of course, it's a private company.
It's a private company,
and,
yes.
And then it needs to be paid, but then government needs to come out and rescue this consignment so that, people are helped. Because it is going to expire in 2021, December.
There's fear it is going to expire. And how many months do we have to 2021? It will not have done the work. NHAS holding these things is perhaps saying, who cares?
I know.
Though it is saying that they're in talks with the, the right people, that's the Ministry of Health, and finding a way of having this consignment released before expiration. And they're supposed to be taken to Butabika Hospital for distribution to the relevant, health centers, for further management. But now that it's 6 months later and they have not been released,
fear is going to expire.
Imagine all that money. Collected from people.
I know.
And then, collected from people.
The kids are just lying there. Either.
And the kids are lying
and
there.
Apparently people who want to use these kids are, they are helpless. They're dying.
I think this is going to demoralize people who usually go for these charity runs.
That's true.
Because if they're focusing on something and then with their hard-earned money and their sweat and their runs. And
then you come out to say that we don't have money to,
It's terrible. Ministry of Health, please do something.
You need to come out and
do something about this as quickly as possible. All right, elsewhere this morning, U.S. West Coast fires. Have you been watching the news? There's been fires all over the West Coast, and we know it is election period for them there. It's equally an election period there, and we saw that President Donald Trump wanted to see what happened there. But Trump is quite unpopular, so he faced it rough. So the fires started early in August, and Trump funds Flames of Climate Raw in California. It has burnt almost 2 million hectares of land, and some 35 people are believed dead.
Of course, climate change skeptic Mr. Trump blames the crisis on poor forest management. Early on Monday, Democratic presidential candidate Joe Biden called Mr. Trump a climate arsonist. He told an event in Delaware that 4 more years of his opponent in the White House would see more of America ablaze. During his visit to the U.S. West Coast, Mr. Trump repeated his argument that poor forest management was to blame as he met Californian officials involved in the battle against the wildfires at a stop near Sacramento in the center of the state.
Well, dismissing one official's plea to not ignore the science on climate change, Mr. Trump said, "It will start getting cooler. You just watch." I don't think science knows, actually. Trump seems to know certain things that many people don't know.
I know.
So at least for one day, climate change is front and center in the U.S. presidential campaign while touring fire-ravaged California. Donald Trump downplayed the role A warming planet could have in the devastation, suggesting temperatures will start getting cooler and that the recent conflagrations were an issue of proper forest management. Meanwhile, Joe Biden went to on the attack, calling the president a climate arsonist. Jesus. Wow.
Big statements here.
Mm-hmm. Very crazy. Their politics events usually get very heated.
Yeah.
Do you see us doing such things of, I can call Henry a climate arson?
No, we don't. We don't, much as we have been freedom,
whatever
that
we
freedom
do, we
of
get
speech,
in trouble.
We have not gone that extra mile.
I think you saw what happened in Bushenyi when somebody alleged that somebody had COVID-19. It was crazy.
Yeah.
Now, quickly, although the environment has typically been a sideline issue, getting scant attention even during the Democratic primaries, the topic is one on which Trump and Biden are sharply divided. And this is on climate change, of course.
Of course, the Trump administration has rolled back more than 70 environment regulations, many of which deal with climate change, while also withdrawing the U.S. from the Paris Climate Agreement. Biden, on the other hand, has moved to the left on the environment, in recent months, expanding on his original plan for spending U.S. dollars $1.7 trillion infrastructure and green jobs over 10 years and $2 trillion over 4 years.
Right. Now, as Trump continued to, you know, talk about a lot of things on climate, when asked by a reporter in California whether climate change was a factor in the massive wildfires, Mr. Trump responded, "I think this is more of a management situation." Like, you know how he talks? Like,
yeah.
Chiller mode. Like, he doesn't even mean
making
anything
faces
he says.
Here and there.
So he claimed that other countries had not dealt with the same level of forest fires despite major conflagrations in Australia and the Amazon rainforest in recent years that experts attributed to the changing climate. Well, we'll wait to see how that plays out, since climate change is becoming a very heated debate for both of them.
But in California, you know, time and again has always had those, you know, fires.
Yes, it has. Yes, it has.
And I don't know what, you know, the Trump administration
to some extent,
can do. Yeah.
To some extent, I want to believe Trump when he says forest management. But why can't he and his government do something about it?
Yeah, because it, California has a history of, you know,
of wildfires.
Of wildfires.
Yes.
And
I remember there's a
I'm
time.
I'm surprised they up to now they have not come
I
out.
I remember there's a time.
That's the solution to it.
There's a time fire almost burnt down Oprah Winfrey's house.
Yes, sure.
I remember there were wildfires at some point and they're really, really bad. So I think the American government ought to do something about those fires. All right. It's about time we went into what's happening in the press. Of course, we'll take a look at what's happening in the press. But before that, let's look at today's quote. Today's quote reads,
"The only things outstanding between you and outrageous success is continuous progress." The only thing standing between you and outrageous success is continuous progress.
That's interesting.
Meaning with the, you know, continuous progress, you can you know, achieve success.
Absolutely. So stay on course and continue that. Trust me, you'll definitely get to where you're headed. Now, we'll look at what's happening in press. What's happening in the press today? You get yourself a copy of the New Vision as 2,000 Uganda shillings and also subscribe to e-papers. Subscribe to e-papers, get access to all the papers of Vision Group, and trust me, that would be a very wonderful experience. Alternatively, yes, download the New Vision Digital Experience app. What am I talking about? Yesterday we talked about it. And you know how, by now you know how it works. Get it on your Android, get it on your iOS, get it on, those systems, the iPhone users, the ones who behave like Subaru drivers. So get yourselves that application and you'll have all these stories either way. In print, okay, not print entirely because it's an app. So you'll get them in video mostly, But also there will be other stories. You can also use text to speech. You know, you can also do, you can follow your journalists, your favorite writers. They're all there. You can listen to XFM. You can listen to Buke de Fama. You can watch Urban TV. You can watch One Law TV. Yes, Buke de TV, Buke de 1 and 2. So
that's true.
We're easing your life, okay? We are changing. We are the only leading, you know, in the news world. That's and we true. Have we have changed the look of things. All right. So in today's paper that is on the newsstands, man kills child, takes head to parliament. We have the detailed story there. And also mayors in the lead, see who is leading where, okay? Her vision, we shall look at it, why gender-based violence cases have spiked in the lockdown. That's all in the new vision. Then we have tear gas disrupts Hoima primaries, malpractice cited in Kampala, NRM mayor flag bearers polls. All that in today's new vision. Please don't miss it out. And of course, past A-level, we have entrepreneurship, we have chemistry, and so much more in mathematics. So get a copy. We have, today being Tuesday, the paper, The New Vision, always carries oil, gas, and infrastructure. And we're looking at what's happening in the oil, gas and infrastructure, industry. Busoga, search for rare earth minerals kicks off. Okay, experts concerned about Kibiro oil spill. There's so much more. We have her vision, get details of why there has been lots of gender-based violence during this lockdown. Mm-hmm. There's also an issue here. My husband got a loan using our land title.
We have been having so many cases.
And in sport, golden pause. Mubilu wins gold at World Championship. Get yourself a copy.
All right. Mubukede na ya tu seda ku mukatale. Kunosulu kumiro karo karo karo. Sipolo kubango mwe gulira. Bakule mbezo mtuwe kugambanti. Mamu kuteno mtuwe ku parliament. Engeri jeba mle mesezo kutusa kukadaga. Babi kule tede mkatabu kwa kabu kede. Mpozi ila bakuletede no mugaga chita taba familia bala corona bakute. Bawandise kuchaba de mkabifu ka NRM akameya wano mubu kede wafona kwa lwalero. Tula banti mubu kede walero. Yabade mkabifu kaba meya ba NRM babi kule tede wano wadebade ovye somirako. Bakuletede yabade Rubaga, Nansana, Kampala Central, Nakawa. Wanawana vena vena bili mneno. Aba chisa aba jamuru chikuru wa Buganda. Baba angudua. Wanda badenga ugula katabu kakabu kedeno. Bango vya somi lako okumanya ebisinga o. Omugaga atadeo bilioni ya satu mwosambu okusula Trump mukalulu. Wacha zitadeo ugula katabu kakabu kedeno. Venga osome ebisinga kao. Wabodo mlala yekumieko umulido. Uno yabadechi deka wali eri. Wacha bentuwe kumako umulido ugula katabu kakabu kedeno. Ovenga osoma ibisinga kwa neno. Mpozi zira bakuleti debio kusoma, mwimu ya P4 na P5. Enevena bili mwenena mkatabo kwa. Nga tugenze kubie mizanyo, tula banti Lampard, avudeo buvi ne Kolb. Enevena bili mkatabo kwa Kolb kedona kwa lwalero. Mpira jia premier, jia season 2020-2021. Enevena bili mkatabo kwa Kolb kede. Kakule kunusu mkumi lukaroka, osoma ibisinga kwa neno.
All right, that is what's happening in today's papers that are on the newsstand. Now, away from that, what happened today in history? Take a look.
In the new vision this Tuesday, a man shocked Ugandans when he turned up at Parliament with a gift for Speaker Rebecca Kadaga. The gift turned out to be a head of a child. Get the details of the story in the new vision. The NRM elected the mayors and councillors for divisions and municipalities. Get the winners and losers in your copy of the new vision. Despite appeals by environmentalists, clearance of Bugoma Forest Reserve has started. Get the full story in the new vision. In a surprise turn of events, Busoga Prince Wambuzi, who had opposed the authority of Chabazinga William Gabula, went and visited him a couple of days before before the 6th coronation anniversary. Find out what Basoga talk about the visit only in the New Vision. These and so much more in your copy of the New Vision this Tuesday.
New Vision, covering the